Fans, please turn your attention to center ice as we honor the Chicago Blackhawks MVH line. The Blackhawks have produced many legendary high-scoring lines in their 83-year history. The Pony Line, the Million Dollar Line, the Scooter Line, and the Savard-Larmor-Secord lines all dominated scoring in their respective eras. But the best-known line of all, arguably, is the Pitt Martin, Jim Pappin, and Dennis Hull line, better known as the MPH line, a trio that dominated the Hawks scoring in the 70s and helped propel the Blackhawks to the Stanley Cup Finals twice. Hawks coach Billy Ray assembled the MPH line when he noticed the complementary styles of number 7 Pitt Martin, a slick, power-skating, two-way playmaking center who could score as well as setting the table for his wingers. On the right side was number 8 Jim Pappin, the epitome of a sniper, a player who had a nose for the net and who could pick his spots. And on the left side was number 10 Dennis Hull, whose powerful slap shot struck fear into the opposing goalies as much or more than his older brother Bobby. Over 3 decades, the MPH line still holds several all-time Blackhawks scoring records. And together, Pitt, Jim, and Dennis scored 726 goals and accrued 1,711 total points while proudly wearing the Blackhawks sweater. The MPH line also excelled during the NHL playoffs. During the Stanley Cup action, the MPH line is still the all-time leading Blackhawks scoring line with 55 points in postseason action. In the 1972-73, the MPH line helped propel the Blackhawks to their second Stanley Cup Finals in 3 seasons, where Dennis Hull scored 9 goals and 15 assists and finished second in playoff scoring. This evening, we are proud to be joined by Jim Pappin, Dennis Hull, and Pitt Martin's longtime partner, Denise Bernice, to celebrate the high-scoring MPH line. In December, the Blackhawk organization and its fans were saddened by the untimely death of Huber Pitt Martin. Pitt's contribution to the Blackhawks as an all-star player, beloved teammate, and captain of the team has solidified his stature as an all-time Chicago Blackhawk great, and Pitt will be sorely missed by all. Please turn your attention to center ice as Pitt's longtime partner, Denise Bernice, Jim Pappin, and Dennis Hull are joined by 2 number 7s to honor Pitt's memory, Carolina Hurricanes defenseman number 7 Nicholas Whalen and Chicago Blackhawk defenseman number 7 Brett Simper for the opening ceremonial puck drop. Thank you. Ladies and gentlemen, please rise and kindly remove all hats and join organist Frank Pellico and soloist Jim Cornelison in singing of our national anthem.
Fight for the ramparts we watch. Welcome in to another sold-out United Center. What a terrific honor before the game. Another Heritage Night for the MPH line. Certainly one of the greatest trios this franchise has ever had. And how cool was it to the Blackhawks miss a trick? How cool was it to have a pair of number sevens come out there for the ceremonial face-off?
Yeah, just
in honor of Pitt Bard, that was great.
Just a touching moment there. And the man in goal tonight, Cristobal Huye. Three shutouts on the season.
But he needs to get going. Here's his last few starts. Four goals against in a loss. Two goals against in a win. Four goals against was pulled. Five goals against in a loss. So he needs to find his form. And Cam Ward, those 30 wins, are third best in the league. The five shutouts are sixth best in the league. The first period on Comcast Sportsnet coming from IPA. I want to say a welcome to our Comcast Sportsnet viewers in Philadelphia who are with us tonight in Poland. Radio rink wide, Bufflin took a hack, and Ward made the save. Bufflin trying to reach for it, could not get control. Ladd did, but his pass off the mark.
Yeah, good opportunity here for Dustin Bufflin, as we talked about in the open, Pat. Playing on a line with Andrew Ladd and David Boland, and head-to-head against the stall line.
David Boland's long wrister, an easy save, then picked up by Seabrook on the shot. Ward handled that. The Canes able to get control. Babchuk, who is one of two former Blackhawk first rounders who are in the lineup for Carolina tonight. Babchuk and, of course, Route 2. Ward played it to the boards, and it missed Gleason. Now Tay is working the wall. Jonathan Tay is jammed to loose. Here's Brower, and he couldn't get rid of a shot.
Good defensive play there by Matt Cullen.
Matt Walker able to clear it to the neutral zone. Campbell fired it back the other way, and Tim Gleason for the Canes. As the Hawks are changing, they'll waltz out easily. Grindamore, the veteran captain, dumped it in. Jalmerson up the right side, and Versteeg left it for Nicholas Jalmerson. He's got some skating room. And eventually winds up in the Hurricane end of the ice. Up by Baleen. Now Versteeg got it back. Drop it to Jalmerson. He walks and wires. And a good save by Ward. And the puck cleared out to center.
Nice play there by Chris Versteeg to win the battle on the boards and get the puck back to the point. And Jalmerson with a good quick shot, but Ward was able to see with nobody standing in front.
Oh, a weak shot handled easily by Huye and Campbell. It was a dreadful minus three the other night, and for the other day, I should say, in three of the last five games that he's played, Brian Campbell's been a minus three, so that needs to improve. Joe Kendall has addressed that the last day or two as the play is deep in the Carolina zone. And it's kicked up the board. Ryan couldn't pick it up. Burrish did. Adam Burrish tipped it up the boards, and it came free, but the Canes on it. And they'll dump it back into Chicago territory. Ryan Campbell has 44 points, which is seventh best among defensemen this year up till now. And Walker fires it back into Carolina territory. Oh, made a good bank pass to Joe Corvo. The Chicago product cleared it to center. Now Cole with a bouncing puck, but it's ruled to be an offside play.
Blackhawk fans, look at the back of your season tickets for savings on your next day.
We mentioned the guy behind the Blackhawk bench having the last change tonight, and look at that, 900 NHL games as a head coach. Here with the Hawks, 35-17-8 since taking over, so 18 games over 500 since assuming the title very early in the season. Well, Babchuk a blowout. This is going to be picked off by the Hawks, but Bufflin couldn't get away from Babchuk, who recovered nicely. It's held in by Keith along Grister. Floats up off the glass. Bolin needs help from Bufflin. He's unable to pry it loose. Now Babchuk moved it ahead, and Cole here to Tarutu, back to Cole. He steps in. Here's Cole with a shot. Good save, Huye, and a fine rush. The best line for Carolina. Now Rutu, who's got 20 goals this season, working the boards. Well covered, though, by Seabrook, and the Hawks come away. Bufflin will fire it back in. The Hawks in need of a change. Babchuk fires it off the glass and out. Was hit hard as he did that. Good check by Brower, who's a bit of physical force here of late. And here's a chance for Kane. Gets to the goal with the backhand. A big save by Ward. And the puck cleared out. Oh, Cam Ward, who has just been terrific, tending goal for the Hurricanes. This is his 16th consecutive start for Paul Maurice's team. He's gone 10-5 in his last 15 in a row. More on the relatively new coach for the Canes in a moment, some of the things he was talking about this morning, which involved Ward. The plays in the neutral zone, and here comes LaRose. LaRose in on Keith. That's an offside play. And the whistle sounds. Talking with Paul Maurice this morning about what he felt needed to happen when he came to replace Peter Laviolette, one of the seven coaching changes that has happened in the NHL this season. And he said one of the first things he felt he needed to do was get the two big guys going. When he was talking about Staal and the goalie, right. Ward, he said Cam Ward needed to know he was going to be the guy. And even if he played poorly or had a bad game or gave up a bad goal, he was coming right back. And since the coaching change, I mean, he's been the guy in the last 38 games. Since the coaching change, there's been only three where Ward didn't dress.
He was the Stanley Cup winner. He was the guy that helped lead the Carolina Hurricanes to their Stanley Cup victory a couple of years ago.
Samsonov chipped it in behind the Chicago net. Eves battles for it there. Now Samsonov pulls up, tries to walk in front, set it open, net, they score. What a pass, Samsonov, and an easy tap-in for the captain, Rod Brind'Amour, but Samsonov made that all happen, and it's 1-0 Hurricane.
Boy, the patience by Sergei Samsonov. In the corner, stops. Campbell loses an edge. Samsonov has time, and then look who's over on the back door, the weak side, the opposite side of the puck here. Give Patrick Eves some credit here, 44 and Waite. He goes in that. Matt Walker's got to make a decision. And then Hugh Waite, there's no way he's going to be able to react that quick. But the play by Samsonov, the quick little stutter step to stop. Campbell goes by, loses an edge, and then that allowed Samsonov that time and space to make that perfect pass. And Rod Brind'Amour isn't going to miss that.
So an early lead for Carolina. And I mentioned in the as we started the broadcast tonight, they haven't just been winning, they've been steamrolling people. This team, Carolina, has won four straight games. And nobody's been closer to them than three goals. That's the closest anybody's been. They've outscored in a four-game winning streak, 23-6. They've been rolling over people. Oh, the Hawks playing one of the hottest teams in the league right now. And to take it back a little further, they've gone 8-2 in their last 10.
You know, and as well, Pat, Hawks have to be aware. Their defensemen like to get involved. So the wingers really have to be responsible to watch for odd man situations coming from Carolina. Well, Comcast has more HD than anyone and bundles to fit your needs. Get 10,000 choices of on-demand programming ready to pick and play whenever. Comcast has a bundle for you. Call 1-888-4 Best TV.
Hawks get a draw, and Kane into the middle of the ice, dropped it back, a long shot fought off by the blocker of Ward. Now in behind the goal goes for Stieg. Kane trying to jam it out of the corner. Penalty's going to be called as a good forecheck effort here for the Hawks, for Stieg was knocked down. Not happy about it. Staal getting a little attention, but the Hawks don't want to do anything foolish here because they should get a power play, which will happen when we come back. 13-33 to go in the first. You remember them? Growing up as a kid,
absolutely,
don't you?
Absolutely, absolutely. I remember when the Blackhawks used to practice, Pat, out, he's take a look at the numbers of the famous MPH line. We used to practice at the Franklin Park Ice Arena.
Yeah.
And I used to either not have school or My mom used to drive me there. I used to watch the Blackhawks practice at the Franklin Park Ice Arena. I remember getting the sticks of Pitt Martin and Jimmy Pappin. Never got a Dennis Hull, but they all had wood sticks, and they were all straight, no curves. And they were the old Northlands. Remember those, Pat?
Oh,
the
yeah.
old Northland sticks?
You could pick up about 5 sticks in today's game, and they wouldn't weigh as much as those old Northlands did.
That's what you call a tree trunk. Those guys used to play with, that's for sure. There's the penalty on Eric Staal. And the Hawks with an opportunity to get on the board, down by one.
7 power play goals for the Hawks in their last 5 games. Brower hacked it along the wall. Kane tried to hold it in, but the Kane's able to clear.
The Hawks have only scored 4 goals the last 2 games, and 3 of the 4 have been on the power play. Let's see if they can build some momentum here.
Campbell's pass, a poor one, is out of reach for Taves, and back comes Joe Corbo. His long wrister is deflected up high. Now Campbell starts it out. Put it on the stick of Kane. Loads it in for Taves. Jonathan Taves with a wrist shot. Good save by Ward. Taves got the rebound, rolling it out to the line. Barker. Now Kane from the corner. Brower to the front of the net. Kane spins to his forehand, but is checked nicely by Gleason. Now Corvo got control. Nice move to get away from Taves, get himself some room.
And the Oak Park native, mentioned earlier, Pat, played a lot of his minor hockey for the Chicago Young Americans, AAA organization here.
Also went to Fenwick High School for a time. Down to 40 seconds left on this Hawk power play. And Duncan Keefe will rewind. Now here he comes. Bolin puts it around the board. Bufflin to the corner. Got help from Bolin. Rolled it back. Keith's long shot. And a blocker save by Ward. Picked up by Seabrook to Keith. His pass deflected to the corner. Now Versteeg was checked. Keith though held it in. Down low Bolin. Buffle in front of the net. Here's Versteeg taking a look. Seabrook got in there too. Here's a shot. Good glove save by Ward. And all that traffic, he's able to locate and hold.
Well, the entry is so important, Pat. We talked about it a lot. See how Carolina's forechecking here. Now stop it right here. Look at two guys here. They're in a little bit of a rotation, but that first good quick pass. Pass by Keith. There's Dave Bolin. Now the Hawks are into their forecheck. A good read there to get the puck in and then that support right away on the dumping.
Keith's long shot. Heck, up a goal post. And Brower just missed tying the game by an inch. Loose puck picked up by Keith. There's Brower taking a look. He's centered. That was too hot to handle for Kane. The penalty over. Both teams at full strength. Rod Brindamore roll it across the ice, and Joe Corvo will chip it in. Seabrook looks for Bufflin. Cleared it to center, and here comes Andrew Ladd. Ladd, the ex-Hurricane, his wrister into the glove of Ward.
Talked to there's Andrew Ladd the other day. He was pretty excited about playing his whole team.
Well, but there's one of those trades. Ladd for Ruto, I think both teams are happy about.
No question.
It's a perfect trade. It worked
look,
for both teams.
Exactly. Different look for both teams. And there's that opportunity. The shot by Duncan Keith. Good screen there by Brower. Good stop by Ward. And then fanned on the first time. And that really hurt. Watch the bottom left of your screen. There's Brower right over the top. And then he gets it the second time off of the post. Great opportunity there. But again, face off, win. And then a shot with people in front of the net.
All right, the Hawks able to get out of their own end, and it'll be dumped in by Tim Brent. Pelletier to the corner. Estelle Pelletier trying to work it loose, but the Canes with possession. And LaRose put it into Chicago territory. Walker. Now Campbell to Pelletier. And the Hawks will chain. Now the Canes get it back into Chicago territory. Staal goes by with a wrist shot. And he just missed the near post for that. Babchuk took a hit to keep it in. But cleared back up the boards and out of the zone.
Good hit there by Big Buff. That's what he has to do. Just keep the game simple, go up and down. Eventually you'll get your opportunities. You're not kidding, Pat. That opportunity for Stahl, a little bit of a curl and drag. It got caught up, and I thought Huey might have slid out of position because of the changeup. He was expecting a little bit harder. He almost slid too far out and just missed that left post in behind Huey.
Right now the Canes picking in. Cleared it ahead, a long shot by Ryan, sticked away by Hue, in behind the goal it goes. Hjalmarsson up the right side, and Burrish able to bounce it to center where Frazier put it deep. Now the Canes come away. Patrick Eves cleared it to center, that pass deflecting, and Ben Eager didn't get very far at the line. Eventually he got it into the zone, but offside is the call with 11 minutes gone in the first. Carolina in front by a goal.
Let's take a look at our Harris Bank check replay. And as you mentioned, partner, Cherty Tree, two of them. Big Buff on former Blackhawk, Anton Babchuk.
Eddie, you were talking about the need for Bufflin, obviously, with the injuries, to pick up his pace offensively. But the one thing you can always control, especially for a guy this big who plays this much, is the physical aspect. And I think I was looking back at this. In 11 games back in the lineup, since he was a healthy scratch, two games in a row. Remember when Joel took a couple guys out? Bufflin was one. Since coming back into the lineup, he's played 11 games. He has been credited with 16 hits in total. Now, you know, sometimes those stat sheets aren't always right. However, I'm going to speculate that the coaching staff feels that that number should be higher.
Yeah. And I think it's that position of wanting to be physical, Pat. But the hits are there. The hits will be there. And Joel Quenneville was a defenseman in the National Hockey League for many years. And when you start running around looking for hits, bad things are going to happen. You're going to get burned. That's going to be open ice. So the hits, if you're moving your feet and you're doing what you're supposed to do within your job description, the hits will be there. And you're right, it is subjective. You know, riding a guy out, to me, that's a hit. You know, it doesn't always have to be the big glass shaker all the time, but for Big Buff, he's got to use that speed and bang defenseman anytime he gets an opportunity. Because you know what's going to happen? Maybe a shift later or down the, it's going to wear down the defenseman, and also they're going to see 33 coming. They might make a quick little move with the puck before they can, and that's where a turnover will happen.
There you go. It may not have an effect that. It may indeed have an effect later in the game. That's what we're gunning for.
In the playoffs, trust me, that's where it really, really pays the price in a seven-game series, so to speak, come playoff hockey.
Fans, don't miss our ending of the exciting Blackhawk action this season.
Well, the Hurricanes have, in 12 minutes of play, been credited with three shots. The Hawks have had 10. But Carolina under Paul Maurice with the lead. Paul Maurice in his second stint as the head coach in Carolina. This is his 675th game as the coach of the Hurricanes. He was in Toronto for a couple of years after being let go in Carolina. Here's Corvo walking up with a long glass. He can really shoot it, Joe Corvo, but a good save by Hue. In behind the goal, Cullen tried to center, bouncing puck. Finally picked up by the Canes. Cullen's pass deflecting and picked up by Whitney. Then Campbell took it away and rolled it out of the zone. Joe Corvo gives a little ground, then finds Eves. Eves dumped it in. Matt Walker up the right side to Adam Burrish. He went backwards with a puck, but Campbell there. And here comes Frazier for Eager. And he's checking along the board. And they clear to the neutral zone, and the Canes will carry it in. Here's Brindamore pulling up, looking for somewhere to go, tried to center. It floats through, and Vallin picked it up. As for Brindamore, Rod Brindamore, who now has goals in three straight games, and that came after 29 games in a row without scoring. That was a long, that's been the longest streak goal drought of his 20 years in the NHL. This guy's been a great player for a long time. And he went through a goal scoring drought the likes of which he has never seen. Did that puck deflect? If not, it's a penalty. It is. And the Hawks are going to go to the power play.
We'll go back to a play inside the Blackhawk zone. There's Jonathan Toews. Watch the play he makes in his own zone. For all you young hockey players out there in your own zone, get your stick on the ice. That pass was going from Cullen to Whitney. If his stick is up in the air, remember the game, Pat, we had against Pittsburgh in here where Pascal Dupuis had his stick up in the air killing penalties in his own zone? It might hit it. If Jonathan Toews has his stick around his waist, chances are that puck gets through, but just give yourself a chance. Just a smart little play there by the captain.
Barkley's long shot tip, deflected wide. Toews chased it down. Now Kane moves toward the middle. Campbell going back door. Kane to Toews. Here's the shot. Ward, good save with a glove on the short side.
Well, just a second longer, Toews can hold on to that puck. Ward was down early. And I think also, too, you talk about Paul Maurice and giving the ball, I guess, so to speak, to Cam Ward. Tom Barrasso, their goaltending coach, has done a heck of a job with him both on and off the ice.
Here's Barker for Campbell. And he floated over his blade. And the puck cleared to center. The race is on. Kane will be able to get to it first as Cullen was out of gas. Patrick Kane, who has 12 points in his last 10, gets the line. Kane will get things set up. Now a long shot by Keith. It's handled by Ward. And the puck cleared up the board, but a good keep by Keith. And shot around by Versteeg to Kane. Left it for Bufflin in the corner. He's checked by Corvo. Here's Boland picking it up. Back to Duncan Keith. David Boland with Seabrook sneaking in. There it goes down low. Bufflin stuck shot. Stop. Oh, and it just eluded Boland. And Boland able to keep it in. Here's Kane, who's still on the ice. Put it in front. And Bufflin couldn't get control of it.
I was just thinking the same thing, Pat, for Kane. It was almost that situation. It was a minute and 30 on the power play, but he was the guy, as you mentioned, that there was a race for the puck. I think it was Cullen that was going for that puck. He had to come all the way back, and next thing you know, there was ice there, and well, sometimes that ends up happening, but probably be a little bit too long being out there on that power play.
Jokinen able to roll it out of the zone, and Campbell shoots it back in there looking for Ladd. Andrew Ladd with Chris Versteeg in the corner. Versteeg is knocked down. Ladd got it back. The penalty over. Here's pass deflecting, and now Jonathan Toews dropped it out to the line. Walker to Campbell. Both teams are at full strength now. Toews has been red hot, a five-game scoring streak for Toews. He put it on Campbell's stick. And in those last five consecutive for Jonathan Toews, six goals he scored. Here's Matt Walker with a long shot, never got through. Chased down by Eves. Both teams are changing on the move as Campbell flipped it ahead. But Versteeg was well covered. That's with that defeat of Bufflin. That's going to be too many men indeed. So the Hawks will be shorthanded when we come back. It's late in the first. The Canes with the lead.
And our Sylvania telestration shows us one too many for the Hawks. Carolina on a power play. And one good chance for the Hawks on that power play before Kane to Toews. Look at Ward. Down early. Down. So that extra second. Hold on to the puck a second longer and then think elevation up and under the bar. And Dustin Bufflin is the man serving the penalty.
Blackhawk penalty.
So the Canes with their first power play of the game, and Duncan Keith able to chase it down. Joe Corvo, the point man for Carolina, as he's been for any team he's been with. This guy can really shoot the puck, Corvo. They will be looking to try to set him up on the power play. Whitney tried to get in, could not. And then Samsonov did. Samsonov, who spent a short bit of time with the Hawks. Oh, he's got the puck. And look down low to Whitney. You got Brindamore front of the net. Here's Cobra. He could not kick to the stick. Oh, Gleason lost it. And back in comes Brower. He dropped it back. Keith on shot. He just missed the near post with a blast. And the Canes get it back to center. Now that rush broken up beautifully by Barker.
Reading and reacting. Talk about it a lot. Duncan Keith jumping into the play with a real good opportunity.
Going into the Hog zone is Stahl. He rolled it rink wide. Back up the boards, and Hawks able to regain control with Boland clearing. 40 seconds for the Chicago penalty. Anton Babchuk is another guy who can really bring it if he gets a chance to tee one up. His pass here deflecting. Rutu cleared it into the zone. And they battle in behind the net, and the Canes dig it out. Stahl spins to his forehand, put it in front. Oh, and it was hacked just wide. Well, they get reorganized. Stahl goes down low. Rutu mishandles. This one held in, though. Right back to Stahl. Quick shot. Good save. Post to post by Huey. There's the U.S. Cellular text question tonight. Which player do you think the Hawks need back the most? 94597 is where to place your vote.
Nikolai Haviboulin activated off of injured reserve. Anthony Miami sent back down to Rockford. So
UA makes the save here. Puck came loose, but the Hawks on it. They're penalty over. Both teams at full strength. And here's Buffley just out of the box. Right into a check, but he couldn't maintain possession. Joe Quenneville sounded this morning as if Haviboulin was close enough that so it's relatively certain you're going to see him at some point this weekend. Have games on Friday and Sunday here in the United Center.
Columbus, boy, are they playing well. Steve Mason, ninth shutout last night against the Boston Bruins. Or maybe, wait, against Pittsburgh tomorrow night. So it'll be the second of a back-to-back for Columbus on Friday here.
Good, because they've been playing some great hockey.
Outstanding.
1 minute
remaining. Detroit back, what, about 10 days ago? And
yeah.
Smoked them and put up an eight spot.
And that matchup, the Blackhawks playing their 65th game of the year tonight. So 17 left after this one. Four are going to be against Columbus. So are the Blackhawks going to be able to hold on to the fourth position of the West? Are the Blue Jackets going to be able to get in the playoffs? These two, they're going to determine their own, each other's fate.
7 points behind right now, Columbus.
Half a minute to go in the period is LaRose. Made a good pass. Brindamore lets it go. Oh, off the tip of the glove of Huey. Picked up by Duncan Keith, who fires it off the glass. It bounced right through the legs of Ladd. Now Keith has to turn quickly. Versteeg stops skating there, and Cullen picked up the puck to the corner. Cullen working well. Now Duncan Keith able to get it back as the first period comes to an end.
I think Chris Versteeg thought that Duncan Keith was there, and he just stopped. You can't assume that the guy's there. You turn the puck over, you got to think about one thing. Get back. And if Dunk's there, great. But if not, good speed and good quickness, good recovery there by Dunk, who probably skated about 8-10 feet to get back to that puck, because Matt Cullen certainly has some good speed to get that opportunity.
14 Chicago shots in the first, 8 Carolina shots in the first on NPH night here in the United Center. But Rod Brindamore has the game's only goal. The Canes with a lead after one.
Blackhawks Hockey on Comcast Sportsnet is brought to you in part by Toyota. See your Toyota dealer now to start saving now. U.S. Cellular, believe in something better. Your Chicagoland and Northwest Indiana Chevy dealers. ChevyDriveChicago.com. Harris Bank, we're here to help. And by Kia Motors. Kia, the power to surprise.
Well, fans, passes for the second annual Chicago Blackhawks Convention, July 17th through the 19th, are available to purchase now at ChicagoBlackhawks.com. Also, book your hotel room at the Hilton Chicago. Each night comes with 2 free convention passes. Hotel guests will have access to special VIP autograph sessions. Book your hotel reservations today by calling 1-800-445-8667.
Welcome back into the United Center, where the Blackhawks trail the Carolina Hurricanes by a goal after 20 minutes of play. You know, these teams don't get together very often, being in opposite conferences, of course, but it's been a long drought for the Hawks against the Hurricanes. The last time Chicago beat a Carolina team was back in April of 1999. And let's look back at the game-winning goal from that night. Wait a minute, who's this guy flying up the left side?
Look at the speed!
He's flying!
Proby, the GW on Artur Zerbe.
And so good old number six.
What the heck is that?
Let's enjoy the celebration. Wait a minute. The guy who set up the whole thing seems to be obscured by the...
Oh, right there, look.
There's Eddie O.
I couldn't believe the pass I made.
It was even flat when it got there for Proby to finish. So, but that was the game winner, a 2-1 Blackhawk win. And that's, look what's happened since then. So,
you know what? I think we should go back and telestrate that. I did a lot of good things on that play.
I think you should. Let's see that again. I'd like to. We've got plenty. Let's come on. Get your crayon out. Let's see go to work here.
All right. For all you young hockey players and old women, men, young boys, young girls, watch. Now stop it right here. Watch the vision. Watch the head to take a look. What's my options? Watch. I look. Where's Proby? Where's Tony? And now watch a saucer pass up and over. Go to the net. Great things happen. And Proby goes short side. What a pass.
Geez, I didn't know you were that good.
That wasn't real speed, was it?
Oh, that wasn't speeding up.
Oh, thanks to our fine crew down in the truck, too.
Absolutely. They had to look long and hard to find the highlight, but eventually they did.
It was in color.
The second period is underway and is brought to you by Corona and Corona Light, official sponsor of the timeout. Relax responsibly. A long shot here from Keith deflected and picked up by the Canes. Now dumped back into the Chicago zone by Cole, and he's going to get to it first. Eric Cole put it into the corner. There's Rutu, threw it in front. Stall a shot. That went wide after deflecting. And the Hawks able to get it out. So this will be an icing call coming against Chicago.
Well, getting in on the forecheck, this number one line for the Carolina Hurricanes. Eric Cole gets body position on Duncan Keith. Brent Seabrook comes over. What's open? Tuomo Rutu. And then Rutu to stall. And a good pad save there. A lot of good things done there by the Carolina Hurricanes. And teams are going to get opportunities. You need your goaltender to make a key stop, especially early. That's what UA did.
Now Keith was up the middle of Boland, who's open. He put it deep. The Hawks looking to change. And picked up by Gleason, who rings it around. Campbell tried to hold it in, not quite. This will be an offside play. Hope the Hawks do go back and touch up, so play allowed to continue. And Corvo shoots it in. Cullen to the corner, got to it first. Here's a centering attempt, deflecting. And a long shot by Gleason. Tip, good save by Huey on a redirect. Oh, that was a terrific stop to keep the Hawks within one. Now Whitney. Challenge on the boards, but got help from LaRose. He looks to center. That pass deflecting. LaRose goes out to the line. Gleason across for Corvo. Cullen is checked. And the Hawks had it, failed to clear. Now it does get out of the zone. Rose right back in there. This wrist shot into the glove of Huey, who will take a whistle.
Boy, good start for Carolina. Hawks with a turnover, not getting a puck out of the zone. A quick shot there by Gleason, a bouncing puck. Change direction a couple times, but just getting the puck. Look at that puck, just kind of skipping along water. Well, frozen water, I guess. And a good opportunity there again for Carolina.
Helmerson brings it up the boards, and the Hawks will get out.
Okay.
The rush got only as far as the blue line. Now Antonov cleared it, and Eves was checked. It rolled up the boards, and Pelletier tried to get it out. Eventually, did. Picked up by Versteeg. Brent heading to the net. Versteeg long shot into the glove. Good location. Ivor Stegman, a better stop by Cam Ward with a stand-up stop.
Yeah, good idea there. Well, fans, you want an opportunity to sit in between the player benches during a Blackhawks home game? Well, now you can. Bid on a new CBOE seat through the online CBOE Seats auction.
Visit ChicagoBlackhawks.com for more info. Chicago Board Options Exchange is proud to be the presenting partner of the Chicago Blackhawks. Those two seats right there, you can say hello to Nikolai Habibulin. Cristobal Oue or Mike Gapski. Mike Havlin's right there, Blackhawk bench. See a little bit of everything sitting in between there, partner. Right in the middle of the action.
Well, that's what a wonderful location. And for any photographers, I'm not sure there'd be a better spot to try to take some pictures than the ones you could acquire there. But you mentioned Nikolai Habibulin, and just to follow up on what we were talking about earlier, I think Blackhawk fans very excited to get him back in the lineup. He's been out for quite some time and now undergoing full practices, and I would think it's safe to say he's going to play either Friday or Sunday. The Blackhawks next are in action after tonight.
I have to believe it's been over a month since he's played.
Here's a chance for Burrish, a shot, a stop. Oh, and a rebound from Campbell with Ward flailing. Campbell had a pretty good look at the net, but the puck was bouncing a little bit. He took a whack, but missed it by several feet. Now icing against the Canes.
Well, a lot of good things happen on this shift here. First of all, the Hawks won a couple battles. They haven't won many early in the second period. Colin Frazier gets it to Adam Burrish. He throws it to the net. Now, Brian Campbell's just trying to get it to the net, and Cam Ward, I think he purposely dives over this puck, Pat, because Campbell's trying to get it to the net, and he thinks it's going to maybe bank over him. See him? He just tried to get it with his stick. He wasn't going to lay down if he was going to stop it. The only thing on the ice when he dives right here is his stick. He dives, and he thinks it's going to hit him, so he avoids the puck so it doesn't bounce in. Campbell's just hurry up, Boulder. Just get it to the net. But good recovery there by Cam Ward.
Great pickup by my terrific color out analyst and our crew here. I mean, you pointed out they always are able to find it. Wow, what a group this trio video contingent is. The great pickup, and I didn't pick up on that right when the play happened, Eddie, but as you said, when Ward sent the puck was coming back near his feet, get him up off the ice. You don't want a deflection off yourself into the goal. He knew the puck was not going to hit the net on its own. Right, here's Kane. Across for Campbell. In behind Tate. Fights off a check. He's got the puck. Got it to Walker. Now Brower's feed just bounced loose. And back is Campbell.
Oh, nice play there by Michael Ryan. Campbell had a chance to move up right away, and they just kind of played a game of cat and mouse and just took away any opportunity. Carolina was able to make wholesale changes because of that smart play by young Michael Ryan.
Andrew Ladd put it deep. And now the Canes will start a breakout. Leeson goes up the middle, and Rutu sends it in. Seabrook looks for Bufflin on the right side. Pushed it up the boards. It didn't get out. Now carried by Seabrook to Keith. Into Boland's corner. Dave Boland threw it in behind. Ladd well covered by Babchuk. And now Cole able to hoist it out to center ice. Heidenberg only get as far as the blue line. Now Keith for Seabrook.
Okay.
Into the zone, Ladd. Strike one. And chase to the board by Seabrook. There's Tim Brent in behind the net. His second game of the year with the Hawks. Brent goes back to Keith. And to send it back in behind. Pelletier. Let's go. Pelletier. A long shot never got through, and Whitney will dump it in. Duncan Keith has been minus four over his last two games. That's real unusual. Loose puck here and just out of the reach of Collins. Pelletier needs help and gets it from Versteeg. Chris Versteeg into the zone, was stripped of it. And LaRose banked it ahead for Collins.
Nice play there by Vallin on Versteeg.
Here's Cam Barker for Jalmerson.
running around at center. Finally picked up by the Hawks, Hjalmarsson. Now into the Carolina zone. Eager picked it up with a shot, handled by Ward, and he gave no rebound to the fourth line, trying to crash the net. This unit has had a couple of pretty good shifts in the game, not trying to stir things up physically a little. The Canes do a pretty good job of protecting the blue paint.
And not a bad idea here for the Hawks to go hard to the net. Go back to the last shift for Duncan Keith. This puck goes from low to high. Stop it right here. Watch Duncan Keith. He's going to go under our Sylvania screen there for a second. But look how he's skating with that puck backwards. And it's that confidence of having his head up, pulling the puck, trying to get it to a better position on the ice to get the puck to the net. That's something that you can practice all the time, but skating with the puck, not only forwards, but backwards as well, just to open up some space, create that opportunity to get the puck to the net. Didn't try to force it through the player, just got it back down, and the Hawks were able to continue on their forecheck. But every single night you can take plays like that, partner. And Duncan Keith just, you know, makes it look so easy, but that's hours and years of practice to be able to make plays like that and know when to do it.
And he is always happy to point out that Trent Yanni is a guy that worked with him tirelessly to improve his stick work. He's always been a great skater, but you know, Yanni realized that for a guy who's not that big, if you're going to be a regular D-man in the NHL, you've got to have a great stick. And clearly Duncan Keith does. And he's very happy to share some credit with Trent Yanni for helping him when he was in the minor leagues.
That's that one-on-one that goes on.
Stahl to Ruutu. He had a bouncer that he flipped wide. Cole goes back down to Stahl. Ruutu to the front of the net. The pass didn't get there, though. Luomo Ruutu chased it down. And then it bounced back out to center. Joni Pitkinen moves in against Seabrook. Pitkinen ripped hard to the board by Seabrook. And Seabrook a physical force. Here comes Bolin to the other end. Now Keith leaves for Bufflin. He had pulled up, though, and that sort of messed up the pass opportunity. And now Bufflin picks it back up.
And a good read there by Hjalmarsson. Carolina had something going. Might have been a three-on-one after the turnover.
All right, 8 minutes gone by here in the second period. Brent Seabrook in his last two games had 10 hits. He adds another right here.
Well, parts of seven seasons these gentlemen played together with the old Hartford Whalers, which now are Carolina. Of course, Joel Quenneville, head coach of the Blackhawks, and Hall of Famer Ron Francis, associate head coach with Paul Maurice of the Carolina Hurricanes, was the assistant general manager for a year and a half, and the coaching change, and they asked Ron to come down to the bench, and one of the guys he called immediately to talk about going behind the bench was his former teammate in Joel Quenneville. These guys have the utmost respect for one another, and can speak from playing with Ron Francis. Pat, one of the nicest guys and probably one of the more underrated players ever to play in the National Hockey League. Second in the history of the National Hockey League in assists. But you know what? He's even a better person. And Ron Francis is going to be successful whatever he does. But the first guy he called and thinking about going behind the bench was Joel Quenneville.
Hawks, let's see, there's a penalty going to be called, and I believe it might be against Chicago here. Let's see what referee Gord Dwyer has for us.
Chicago penalty, number 19, 2 minutes holding.
Chad LaRose has had a real active game. Oh boy. I thought Jonathan Taves did a heck of a job there. I didn't see it. Maybe it was maybe right before that, but boy, I thought he did a nice job there of doing what he could to prevent LaRose from getting in the middle of the ice.
Ruutu goes across the corner, a long shot. Hit the goalpost, the outside of the pipe. Well, the Canes keep it in. Ruutu will look back to Corvo. Moves toward the middle, then put it to Babchuk. A shot, good save, and a second save by Huey. Rebound is loose. He's trying to capture. He did not. It's in behind the net. And chop back to Anton Babchuk. Now Stahl to Corvo, bouncing puck, he has a problem. Oh, what a job by Corvo, or it would have been a breakaway. Here comes Seabrook. Joe Corvo had a case of the happy feet and nearly a disaster for the Hurricanes, but even as he was flailing every which way, he was still able to locate the puck and tap it away from the oncoming traffic. He
covered nicely.
And now another penalty coming up here.
Wow, are they calling Ruutu for diving?
Ruutu is being taken off the ice indeed. Or is he calling a pair? Let's see. This again is referee Gord Dwyer, and it is only Ruutu coming off.
Carolina penalty, number 15, 2 minutes diving.
Well, the former Blackhawk. There's Christopher Stieg. You got that stick parallel around, looking for Stieg. He looks right at the referee, letting him know that he didn't do anything. So the diving call there, and look at Corvo. Nice, get slippery. I'm sure. I think he took that class at Fenwick, did you?
No.
What do you call that? The two-step or whatever? Boy, he has played really well. And just mentioned about coming from the Ottawa Senators. You think they could still use him there? Mike Commodore and Corey Stillman for Joe Corvo. Looking for a puck moving defenseman. Very good one.
Four on four. Here's a blast. Oh, that hit Huey up high. He's able to hold his ground, make the stop. And that one stung him a little. Here comes Boland to the other end. Trying to get around a check. He looked as if he could have gone right to the middle of the ice, but eventually a shot deflects up high. Now in behind the goal is Boland. Threw it out in front, but it's picked off by Cullen. And Mark Cullen will send it into the Blackhawk zone. Whitney dropped it. Pitkinen takes a look back. Here's a blast. Had a save by Huey. Rebound to Pitkinen. He tried to center. The good stick of Ladd broke up the feed. In behind the goal, Seabrook corrals. And a whistle on the play. They're going to check on Huey. He might have indicated that he was shaken up. So the referee has stopped the play to check on the condition of the goaltender, who was really hit hard up high. Might have been right in the headgear. And that's what he is checking out. We've played halfway through the second period. It remains 1-0 Hurricanes.
1-0 lead for Carolina over the Blackhawks. And Yoni Pitkinen with that hard shot. Wasn't that high. Huey was down on his knees before the puck got to him. And like what the referee did, stopping the play when hit the mask of Cristobal Huey. I'd like to congratulate the Mite Silver Sabres hockey team for winning a tournament this past weekend, and a special congratulations to David Bartley. Way to go, guys, and keep up the good work.
All right, in 6 seconds, the Blackhawks will have a power play for a minute. Well, back of the goal it goes, and Cullen spins to his forehand. And he gets to the front of the net. He got rid of a shot, and Huey was able to smother it. And the penalty to Chicago over. So the Blackhawks now with the extra man opportunity.
Oh, great work here by Matt Cullen. Keep away there for about 10 or 12 seconds. Fights off a check there by Brian Campbell. Huey down, and he tried to elevate this puck. Look where Huey is. Cullen sees that, and he just tries to throw the puck up and under the bar. What a heck of a shift there by Cullen.
Campbell to Barker. And back is Gleason, hit by Brower. The Hawks get the puck back. Barker leaves for Kane. Patrick Kane. Campbell going back door. There's the pass. Oh, it deflected before reaching Campbell. And Barker back for
it. The stick of the goaltender Ward.
Barker with five assists in his last five games. Put it on Campbell. Stick, good pass. Here's Kane to the goal. The shot. And it's saved by Ward. And the rebound cleared. Damn, Ward, a huge stop after a great pass from Campbell. Sent Patrick Kane right to the net. And now the Carolina penalty over. They've got the odd man rush. Here's Stahl trying to go to the middle. Great play, Seabrook. He broke another pass. Then Corvo, a shot handled by Huey with no rebound. So Brent Seabrook, after the Hawks denied at one end, made a big play in his end of the ice.
Well, an opportunity there for Carolina, and it's time for our Ford. Great save. You mentioned it, Pat. The great pass there by Brian Campbell to Patrick Kane. He tries to throw the puck between the legs, the five hole. There's the pass on it. Kane settles it down. There was some room there. Look at the stick of Ward. He opened it up just a little bit. Kane wasn't able to find its way up and over the stick.
Chance here for Ruttu, but he shot it up high. Now Boland in the corner, battling with Stahl. Stahl came up with it, then was checked. Centering attempt finds Wallin. Now Versteeg comes away. Boland into the zone. Ladd heading to the net. Boland pulls up. And the pass was redirected. One. Walker. And a jam loose, but good support from Versteeg. This Versteeg weaving slowly to center.
Okay.
Loads it into the Carolina zone. And the puck cleared back to center where Hjalmarsson. And it knocked loose. Ue comes out of the goal to sweep it. He didn't get it out. LaRose centered, quick shot. Didn't get through it. Maybe it's a deflected up high from Cullen. Now LaRose goes back to Babchuk. His long blast is blocked. And Eager looks for help. It comes from Brent, who shot deflects out of play. Well, I had a chance to talk to Paul Maurice for quite some time this morning about his time since retaking the coaching reins in Carolina. I said to him, who's your best defenseman been since you've taken over? And he was very quick to answer. Joe Corvo, the Chicago boy who's been with a couple of organizations now. And talking to Joey before the game tonight, he would love to stay in Carolina. He's got one more year left in his contract. He says that he doesn't feel like he has to break the bank. He wants to be wanted, wants to be in an organization that is happy with him, and he's certainly happy with them, and that's the way it stands right now with the Canes. We'll see what happens down the road, but Maurice was talking about Joe Corvo. Every game, he's like Keith and Seabrook with Hawks. He plays against the other team's best line. This is an offside play. He plays against the other team's best line. And, you know, you could get an argument from Joni Pitkinen about who's been the best D-man. Sure. Pitkinen plays 25 minutes a night. But Corvo, the opinion of his coach, has been the best defensive man that he's had.
I talked to Joe Corvo the other day when I was in Carolina, and he mentioned how much he likes it there in Carolina and the opportunity that he has been given. And I think just talking from management with the management of the Carolina Hurricanes about the Chicago guy, that they certainly would like to keep him in the mix, because those type of players, those type of defensemen, they're tough to find that can play offensively and move the puck up to the forward.
Seabrook tees it up and fired it wide. Duncan Keith looks for Versteeg, who's checked immediately. Ladd carried on. Now Boland. Cole let it roll loose on the boards. And Corvo has a second chance to pick it up. Cleared it to center, Eric Cole. Unable to get very far. Versteeg to Boland, kicks to the stick. Boland trying to make a move, then a quick shot. Handled by Ward, rebound is in behind the net. And finally the whistle does sound.
A lot of the people in to the right of Cam Ward saw that puck on top of the net and saw the net bulge, and after the puck ended up in the back of the net. Did you hear me laugh a little bit? Our great audio. You talk about our great crew, but our great audio as well. Eric Stahl was going up trying to get that puck, and the linesman was in the way, and Eric Stahl yelled at the linesman, like, get out of the way. And the linesman said, where do you want me to go? You're coming full bore here. Ellie could go one way or the other. Those types of things happen all the time, you know. Of course, I mean, the referees and linesmen, I mean, they're scrutinized in a lot of situations, but you know what? They got a tough job. There's nowhere to hide out there. Guys are flying at them, pucks are flying. Look at that crazy bouncer, almost hit the referee. But sometimes they just get in the way, and, you know, they're not trying to. That's for sure. So sometimes there's nowhere to hide.
And there's no outlet for them. You know, they used to be able to grab the top of the glass that was a lot shorter along the sides of the rink, but they can't do that anymore, so. Not an easy job indeed. line, put it behind the Hawk net, picked up by Campbell, ties the right side, and Burrish couldn't get it out. Walker then did, and Adam Burrish unable to get away from Vallin. All right, here's a long shot by Barker, but that hits some traffic. And Ryan will put it back into Chicago territory. We're down to 5 minutes remaining in the second period. One goal has been on the board, scored by the Carolina captain, Rod Brind'Amour. Here's Kane trying to change that, but couldn't get rid of a shot. Held in by Barker. Taves. Well, checked by Collins. And Helmerston held it in. Gleason works the boards, and the puck picked up by the Canes. Whitney pokes it back into Chicago ice. Now it came loose. Oh, and just over the stick of Seidenberg and out of the zone. The board, Seidenberg keeping it in. Taves in his way. The Brower sends it back into Carolina territory. This is going to be icing, though, against Chicago. The Hawks wanting a change, and of course, now will not be able to. Take a look at our Toyota Moving Forward upcoming schedule. Columbus, the team that has been red hot here on Friday night, and then Sunday, one of those great matinee games that the New York Islanders making their only appearance. Why did they stick us on the road on St. Patrick's Day? We'll be in the swamps of New Jersey, but wow, what a great matchup that'll be. The Devils have been playing great hockey with Brent Sutter.
A great matchup. Of course, Martin Brodeur closing in on a couple records, career wins and shutouts, and that building, Pat, is an unbelievable facility that the New Jersey Devils have right in downtown Newark. The Rock, they call it, the Prudential Center. A beautiful building and a great challenge for the Hawks to go into New Jersey next week.
Oh, off a Chicago skater redirect. Great save by Huey. Now Vallin tries, didn't get it through.
Buff again broke his stick. Babchuk, the last slap shot, snapped his stick in half, and now Vallin with a wrist shot. Get that invoice. Get that money back. you know what? Hey, if he had a wood stick, it wouldn't happen, right?
That's right.
Wood is good.
And now a whistle on the play. The linesman appeared to have stopped the play here. I don't know if whether we have too many men or not. But we have 3.5 to go in the second period. Let's hear what was going on the ice that Eddie was talking about minutes ago. Welcome back to the UC, where I don't know whether you've been able to notice the public address announcer tonight, but it might be a familiar voice to those of you who have been longtime Hawk fans. 42 years of the public address mic for Harvey Wittenberg. He's here tonight to step in for Gene Honda, and what a night for him to come back as they honor the MPH line, and he announced all of their goals and assists that happened in the old Chicago Stadium. Terrific guy, a great Blackhawk fixture for many years, and great to hear his voice on the PA system tonight on West Madison Street.
Blackhawk through and through, and can still hear it now. Blackhawk goal.
Now a loose puck came right through the slot area, comes back to Seabrook, who tries, but had his shot blocked, and Cole is away. Eric Cole will drop it back. There's Route 2 with a shot, and saved by Huey. And the rebound taken by Versteeg with a 2-on-1. He's got Bolin with him. Versteeg into the zone, drives in, shoots. He scores! The Blackhawks have tied the game with a 2-on-1 from their own blue line all the way to the other end. 1-1.
Well, time now for our Buick Pontiac GMC drive to the net. And one of the guys we talked about in the open, Chris Versteeg, a 2-on-1 after a big stop by Cristobal Huey, just getting it to the net. Look, his head up. Can I pass it? No, I'm just going to get it to the net. And that puck got through. Cam Ward
Timely save at one end, as you mentioned, Pat. And Christopher Stieg ties it up here late in the second.
For Stieg, who for quite a while here of late has been sporting the playoff look. A lot of facial hair growth and he's clean shaven today. Now, I don't know if there's any correlation or not, but he just scored his 18th of the year.
I think we need to talk about Harvey a little earlier.
Assisted by Keith at 17:08.
All right, Harvey. I'm going to speculate that's the first time he's ever been on camera announcing the goal and assist. Which, of course, all those years, the 42 seasons that he was the PA guy, there wasn't any home TV. Sorry. Now a loose puck for the Canes. Here's a chance for LaRose and a diving stop by Huey. Rebound taken by Corvo to the middle with a long shot. Huey fought it off on the right pad. And the rebound cleared out of there by Brouwer.
Boy, Huey has made some really, really good stops. And again, allowing the Hawks to get some energy, gain some confidence, keeping this within one. And the big goal there by Versteeg.
Here's Corvo. His stick tied up by Eager, who forced a turnover, but Hawks couldn't get the puck to the net. Bufflin out of the corner, and Eager spins to his backhand, could get it through the traffic. And the Canes, Seidenberg able to get it back to center. Back in comes Eager. Eager with a shot, fought off by Ward with a left pad. Eager threw it across the ice, and Patrick Eves will not only make a good pass to Brindamore. Had he picked that up cleanly, it would have been a two-on-one, and a big collision back into the Carolina zone between Eves and Frazier. And the play was stopped immediately. It's going to be on Patrick Eves.
Yeah, Colin Frazier went over to finish his check, and Eves got the elbow up. Carolina turned the puck over at their own blue line. And Ben Eager was coming out of the zone, coming in. It was a semi two-on-one. Had to get rid of it real quick, but a good pad save there by Ward.
Well, the Hawks with a late power play here in the second. Kane walks toward the circle. There's Brouwer, Taves in the middle. Kane couldn't find the puck. And Vallin got it out with his backhand. Now Patrick Kane or Cam Barker. Brouwer couldn't get it away from Gleason. Half a minute to go in the period. Taves up the boards for Brouwer, who rings it around. There's Campbell. Brouwer unable to pick it up off the boards. Patrick Kane settles it down. Kane looks back to Barker, and again Kane moves in, shoots one. Barker saving a good one by Ward. Campbell has a broken stick, kicked it ahead, and then it's jammed back the other way. Chased down by Cole. Eric Cole turns to the forehand. Oh, and a good play defensively by Barker to get back. That might have been a decent scoring chance for the Canes. But that will finish the second period.
Boy, broken sticks everywhere. Campbell, Brouwer just broke his stick. Pat, we talked about the linesman and referee. There's nowhere to hide. Watch the right part of your screen. There's linesman Derek Nansen. Eric Stahl's just trying to get this puck in deep. So he tries to go up the boards, and it just buckles. Derek Nansen.
Each team, sorry, each team had 10 shots in the second. 24 total for the Hawks, now 18 for the Canes. But the only goal of period two from Christopher Stieg. Been a while since he lit the lamp, but he notches number 18, and we're tied.
Blackhawks Hockey on Comcast SportsNet is brought to you in part by your local Hyundai dealer. Now with Hyundai Assurance, we've got your back for one full year. Go to MyChicagoHyundai.com for details. GEICO. 15 minutes could save you 15% on car insurance. Visit us at geico.com or call 1-800-947-AUTO. And by Ford. Visit your Chicagoland Ford store and drive one.
Welcome back to the United Center as the game in doubt as we get ready for the third period. Assistant coach John Torchetti has been nice enough to join us behind the bench. You were down 1-0 for the longest time, Torch, but what's your assessment of the first 40 minutes for your team to this point?
Well, with the 3 minutes left, we're starting to get a little bit worried because that would have been five straight periods for Ward with a shutout. So it was good to get one on the board, and now hopefully we can play a little more confidence and get a little more pucks to the net with more traffic.
What do you have to do for to gain that confidence and build off of that that goal on that two-on-one? You guys have had some odd-man situations, Torch, but not able to cash in. What are those things that you need to build on the confidence?
Well, I think just coming out of the cycles, Edzo, you know, we've got to come out of those cycles maybe with one chip and taking pucks to the net down low. We're still trying to, you know, make two or three passes, and they're condensing on us, and we're not getting nothing from it, and recognize that their forwards are shrinking, and we've got to get pucks to the point on the strong side and get shots through.
Been a real nice night for your goaltender so far, hasn't it?
He's come up big. He looks great tonight. He's made a couple of really, really big saves for us, and hopefully he can keep doing it for 60 minutes and we can get a couple of goals for him.
All right, good luck in the third.
All right, thanks, guys.
I think it has been a real nice bounce back game for Cristobal Huey, and I mentioned right at the start of the contest that you know, the last few outings have not been what he has been accustomed to delivering to his team, and he has been tested pretty severely in the first of two periods, and only one has got by him. And so many times, Eddie, you pointed this out on several occasions, you're down a goal, a great chance against you, and you know, you need, those are one of those categories where you put it in the big save area.
It was a handful in that second period. In this third period, it's brought to you by your local Hyundai dealer. What a day for a Hyundai. Go to mychicagohyundai.com.
Short power play for the Hawks as we open up the third. Kane pulled up a little bit as he's heading to the middle, out of traffic there, and the puck rolled loose, and it's covered by Ward. Jonathan Toews, who we mentioned earlier, has a five-game scoring streak on the line and six goals with two assists over the last five in a row. 11 goals in his last 11 games. He's beaten on this draw, though, by Cullen. The Hawks will have to chase back.
They've had some good movement. They've had some really good scoring chances on their power play. They'll stay with it and keep getting people to the net.
And Seabrook chips it up the boards. Goes all the way around to Cam Barker. Toews is in deep. Brower to the front. Here's Barker for Seabrook. And Seabrook looks for Brower, but the puck taken away.
A little different look on this power play with Cam Barker patrolling the point. You got Brent Seabrook back on there, and I think just looking for maybe a one-time situation, Pat. Have a little bit of a rotation, have that shooter on the opposite side. The Hawks like to work their power play on their right side, so we'll be on the left side of Carolina. So if Patrick Kane is working that area there, you have a right shot on the other side of the ice. You have somebody there to be able to one-time that puck. So if it moves to Barker, he walks the line, he can shoot it or throw it down to a guy shooting the right side and then get that opportunity towards the net. If it's a left-hander, he has to stop it first.
Loose puck centered by Versteeg, but it was bouncing every which way, and now the Canes will be able to come out. The rush broken up at the line. Ruutu tried to pull up to stay onside, but couldn't quite.
I saw Tuomo Ruutu the other day, and he was really complimentary of his time here in Chicago, and he just had heard from a lot of people that the fans were back and the support has been tremendous, and also too, games are on TV now as well, he said, so. Tuomo Ruutu is one of those guys, just an infectious personality, and he hit it on the head earlier tonight. I mean, that trade has worked out very well for both teams, and most importantly for the guys that got traded, and of course Andrew Ladd's come in and really fit in nicely, especially this year.
Paul Maurice was talking about Tuomo Ruutu this morning and pointed out what those of us who experienced him in Chicago already knew. He's just a happy guy, you know. He loves this game, can't wait to get to the rink and play. He's usually one of the first guys at practice and one of the last guys to leave. He really enjoys his teammates. He's a fun guy to be around. He almost always has a smile on his face. He's got a twinkle in his eye. So an easy guy to root for. And there you see that there are some connections in this game tonight. And by the way, Michael Layton, I also saw this morning, and, you know, a nice kid who's had a good year in Carolina this season as the backup to Cam Ward. And there's a guy that was really put in a, what I would call an unfair situation. Fans may remember a few years ago that Jocelyn Thibault was supposed to be the goalie for the Hawks. He got hurt. And Craig Anderson and Michael Layton had to carry the mail. Here's Cullen trying to walk in. His shot block. Hawks going to get a penalty. Cullen picks it up. Put it in front. Swing shot. Oh, and UA might have gotten a piece of that with a right pad. Rebound is loose, and the Canes able to keep it in. They've got six out there. As the goalie's off to the bench. Now a centering pass from Whitney picked off, and finally the Hawks get control, and the Canes will go to the power play.
Well, it's going to be on Troy Brower.
Two minutes tripping.
Right before that real good chance by Matt Cullen. Left part of your screen. The stick of Brower along the leg of LaRose. And a nice play there by Sergei Samsonov. The quick little fake. And boy, Huey made a sneaky good save. Now Nutu gets a stick up around the face of Brent Seabrook. If he is cut, this will be a 4-minute penalty if he is bleeding.
Go to examine and take a real good look at Brent Seabrook, who does not appear to have been cut.
Oh yeah, that stick kind of rode up the shaft of the stick of Siebes. And it is a 4-minute penalty.
Wow, so a double minor given to Rutum because he just got that sequence of minor penalties. The offensive zone draw for the Hawks with four skaters aside here.
Carolina penalty.
So in a 1-1 game, a big
double minor
sequence
4 minutes
coming up.
At 2:36. Carolina penalty, Rutu. A 4-minute penalty for Ohio.
And here's Seabrook coming out. Boland has the puck up with Ladd. David Boland left it for Andrew Ladd. Here's the shot into the glove of Ward. Let me just finish what I was talking about with Michael Layton. Tebow's supposed to be the goalie. He gets hurt. And so the Hawks wound up with a couple of kids, Craig Anderson and Michael Layton, playing goal. They were both in their early 20s. They were playing behind a bad hockey team. And oh, by the way, the goalie coach at the time was the Hall of Famer Vladislav Trajak, who at the time was running for some political office in Russia. And he never came over. Not one time all year was the goalie coach for the Hawks, helping these young kids, and you know,
learn on the job, right?
Oh, well, learn on the job. How about a little instruction? How about a little help? How about a little backing? And I believe that was the last year that Trajak, and let me just make it clear, Trajak did a lot of good things when he was with the Hawks as a goalie coach. I mean, he was wonderful in Ed Belfour's career, and he helped a lot of other goalies. But in that circumstance, which was a dire circumstance for the Hawks and these young kids, he wasn't there. Here's a Buffalo with a shot and a save by Ward. Great chance for Buffalo, but Ward beat him.
I think at that time you needed somebody around all the time.
Yeah.
With those two young guys.
Cullen looks to walk in, but lost the handle. And here comes Brian Campbell. Campbell's going to get the line. Just on a change is Ladd. He pulled the trigger. And a save by Ward. Reba. Oh, and a goal was saved by Seidenberg. Duncan Keith had the lead on his stick. Seidenberg with the skate save. Back come the Canes. Here's Corvo. It just rolled off the end of his stick as he tried to go forehand.
Corvo looking for back-to-back games with a goal. The other night against the Rangers, won 4-on-4. Before that opportunity for Corvo. What a great individual effort by Big Buff. Dustin Buff working his way out of the corner and forcing Cam Ward to make a good stop.
Now Seabrook. Looking for Boland.
All right, Cam!
Head for Ladd, who's able to pick it up. Now Boland walks in. They back away. Boland to the net. He got Ward down, but couldn't get rid of the shot. Boland then checked. Now the Hawk penalty over. Chicago on a power play for 2 minutes. Now picked up by Barker. In behind the goal it goes. Boland looking for a little help. Barker fires it in deep. Here's Kane off the end. Boards in front of Brower! And the Hawks are in front! Patrick Kane, goal mouth to Troy Brower. It's 2-1.
they're work away from the puck. David Bolin gets that puck back to Cam Barker. And Barker cannot get it directly to the net. So what's he do? He shoots it off the side of the net. And Kane, with those quick hands, takes it from behind the net to the front. And look at Troy Brouwer. Goes to the weak side, the opposite side of Patrick Kane. And a power play goal. But a heads-up play there by Bolin to get it to Barker. The recognition. I can't try to shoot it through the penalty killer, so I'm going to get it off the side of the net and in the quick hands of Patrick Kane.
That feels good for many reasons, I'm sure, for Troy Brouwer, but among them is he was inches away from scoring on that first period. The puck off the post that was laying a foot from the goal line. Troy coming to wax at it, but unable to connect. That would have been haunting him had he not finished that opportunity, but he did, and the Hawks are in front.
And number 25, Cam
Barker. Handed it behind the net. Picked up finally by Kane. A terrible pass is picked off. Here's Ruttu. He fell down as he was ready to shoot. Romo Ruttu should have had a great chance, but it never was generated. Now Andrew Ladd back in. His wrister, handled by Ward. Gave the rebound right to the middle, but the Canes on it. And now it's cleared to center, but has nearly stolen away. Nolan Frazier working the boards. Gleason sends it forward, and LaRose sends it in. And behind the goal, Hjalmarsson. Now Barker around to the right side. Burris is checked. Frazier poked it loose. Now Barker is pressured, lost it. And over the side, Whitney finally is knocked off his stick and out of the zone.
Nice quick stick there by Hjalmarsson.
And Babchuk knocked down by Eager.
Can he get him again?
He's going to get him again. Two for two on this shift for the Hawks, 55.
Three for a dollar.
Yeah, was it last time with Turdy Tree down here? A big right. Buff.
Now Rod Brindamore throws it into the Chicago zone. And they're coming to life in the United Center again. There's a long shot by Vallin. It didn't get through, deflecting out of play. 7 minutes gone by in the third. The Blackhawks are in front on Troy Brouwer's 10th of the year. Here's our update on the U.S. Cellular text question tonight. Who have they missed the most? That's the update, the final answer on the postgame show.
A special hello to everybody out at Trackside in Arlington Heights, especially manager Mike Sparica. Sure they're watching Trackside. Hard to believe Hawthorne just opened their 100th year anniversary, Hawthorne Racecourse.
Yeah, wow.
Carey family, congratulations to them. Hard to believe this season. We're moving down the stretch right now.
Eddie will be there soon. The Canes, Ruttu trying to pry it out of the corner. He did, but his pass was tipped. Now in behind Stoller. Wrap around. UA beat him to the post. And this one's going to be held in by Seidenberg. Then came loose to Ladd. Scooped it out to center. Versteeg pulls up. Rink wide. Oh, just missed Bolin or he would have been gone. And now Corvo for Carolina. Their pass led and picked off beautifully by Duncan Keith. Seidenberg comes away. Whitney tapped it deep. And now the Hawks back the other way. Here's Taze. Donovan Taze. He'll drop it back. Walker, the pass was at his feet, though. The Canes look to counterattack. The race for the loose puck as Whitney moves in on Campbell. Shoot! Walker saves UA. Rebound to Taze. And now here comes Kane, racing up the board. Patrick Kane, a spin-a-rama with a backhander that was blocked. And the goal knocked off the moorings as Brouwer went crashing in there.
Well, after the game, stick around for Smirnoff Vodka Blackhawks post-game live. Highlights, post-game reaction, and analysis with Josh Moore and Steve Conroy. Don't miss Smirnoff Vodka Blackhawks post-game live immediately. After the game on Comcast SportsCenter. You were laughing before.
Whoa. Well, I know where you're going, and I and I love it. But, hey, by the way, I want to offer a tip of the cap to my partner this evening. And more on that in a second as the play is in the Carolina zone. Whitney moves it ahead to Eaves. Cleared it ahead. Samsonov toward the middle. Sergei Samsonov pass off a skate. And Eager sends it in. But Eddie O, you know, how's it? For anybody who's watching and listening, you know, how busy have you been since Saturday? Well, this man in 5 days has done 5 games in 4 different cities. So thanks for remembering my name, first of all. But great job tonight, as you always do. But I tell you what, I'm not sure I could keep that pace. So
thank you.
Nice going, Eddie O. All right, here's the battle deep in the Carolina zone. The Canes. Edberg bounced it back the other way. Retrieved by Brian Campbell. Brian tapped it forward. Here's Convoy looking to move in. His shot is handled by Huey with no rebound.
Well, a missed opportunity here for Carolina. Left part of your screen. There's Jokinen. Watch what he does. This is a 2-on-1. He stays back. And I know he wants that puck to get passed by Convoy, but if he recognizes to get to the net, that pushes back the defense, and then that gives Convoy more of an opportunity to get in closer to Cristobal Huey. And he never even really looked. He just got that stick in a shooting position, and Hawks will certainly give up that shot from 35 feet out instead of 25 or 20. With the recognition of kind of just staying to the outside, put the Hawks in a pretty good position in their own zone.
You know, we've had a man from each team thrown out of this face-off circle. Well, this time, Ryan comes in against Burrish. Boland let it go back to Corvo, whose long shot is wide. Jokinen sends it in deep. Convoy. This is a line that plays rarely for Paul Maurice, but they're out there now looking for the tying goal. Boland, however, pushed it back the other way.
Yeah, that was a good play by Jalmerson. He's able to block that shot and get the puck out of the zone. That puck gets through, Carolina might have something going.
Eager looped it back to the Carolina blue line. We've reached the halfway point of the third now. 2-1 in favor of the Hawks. And the Blackhawks trying to get going on home ice to the level that they had been at for the first two-thirds of the season. But entering play tonight now, in the last 9 Hawk games, they had only 3 wins in this building. 3-4-2. The last 9 here. Looking to rectify that bad streak. The Canes get back into the Chicago zone. A pass broken up by Keith to Babchuk. Anton Babchuk fights his way in behind the net. He's greeted there by Seabrook. Now held in. Seidenberg's long blast. Never got through. Quick shot. Oh, Huey! Good save! Oh, that puck after it was blocked went right to the stick of Babchuk. And he got rid of it in a heartbeat. Huey beat him. Now Stahl looking to move back in. Did. Stahl, Christer. Oh, that was fought off awkwardly, but Huey made the stop. And the puck cleared out.
Pucks have to change the momentum here. Carolina's got a little something going here.
Here's Kane looking to do just that in on Gleason. Kane's going to wait for help. It comes in the form of Walker, a long shot handled by Ward. Now Whitney didn't get very far. Brower chopped it back. taken by Gleason. Gleason, the ex-LA King, let his pass go awry. Weinberg has to chase back. And Fraser right there with him. Hooked it up the boards. Finally taken by LaRose. He gets the line. Popped it back from Samsonov, and a return pass knocked LaRose down, or at least he was off balance, and ends up back in the neutral area.
Watch out.
That right into the Canes bench, it appeared, as we get down to 7.5 remaining in the third. Hawks 2, Canes 1.
Well, 24 shots on goal for the Carolina Hurricanes, and some real good stops by the man from France, using his mask on that one. Good stop there on Matt Cullen. I think the key in a lot of these, Pat, haven't been those second and third chance opportunities. You take a look at the numbers tonight and the last two starts for Cristobal UA. It's been one and done for the most part. And if there have been rebounds, Hawk defensemen have been there to be able to clear the puck. And UA's, as you mentioned, has really bounced back here tonight.
Eager is going to try to chase this down. Babchuk swats it loose. Bufflin took a whack. And now picked up by the Canes. A good strip by Eager. Put it in front for Fraser. Backhander. Good save, Ward. And Brindamore. And he'll clear it back to center. Samsonov to Brindamore. Brindamore has the Carolina goal tonight. His third straight game with a tally. Samsonov dancing in. Brindamore will let it go. That was a flutter ball off a stick block. An easy save that turned out for Cristobal Huey. Hey, our producer tonight for Blackhawk Hockey on Comcast Sportsnet is the great award-winning Mike Leary. Our director is Bulldog Dave Turner. Our associate producer and numbers man is Dave Ross. Our stage manager, Christine Charbonneau. Our stage manager, Mark Harper, and the executive producer tonight, Jim Corno Jr. We thank them all. We don't get to thank them as often as we should on a nightly basis, but those are the folks who make it all happen in the truck. And we're very grateful for their help always. And a Hawk power play is on the way here.
Well, Eric Cole dives and gets the stick around the midsection and drops the stick to try to sell that it was just an accident, but you get that stick in the midsection. Dave Bolin with good speed, and the Hawks with a real big opportunity here.
Eric Cole, 2 minutes for tripping at 13:28. Carolina Penley Cole, 2 minutes
now
for tripping.
Troy Brower goes back to Campbell. Barker. Now Kane with it. Cameron Barker with a long slap shot, never got through. Good play by Campbell to get his stick and poke the puck to Kane. Barker. To Campbell, touch pass for Kane. Side of the net, Taves. Backdoor Campbell. Oh, and a save by Hewitt, by Ward. It's taken out by Bart, by Campbell. He walks in. Campbell goes down low to Troy Brower. Now Patrick Kane. To Barker, his long blast gobbled up by Ward.
Well, a lot of different looks here for Joel Quenneville on the power play. Remember the one power play a little bit earlier? He had Brent Seabrook over here, a right-handed shot. But Campbell does everything right, just unfortunately, Cam Ward makes an unbelievable stop. Desperation left to right. Puck comes right through the paint and then the right pad. No hesitation at all by Campbell. Got it all. And just a better save. Great pass there by Taves.
Right a minute for the Hawk power play. Speeding it for Steak. Trying to get to the goal. And just the puck escaped him in the last moment. And Ward able to cover it up long enough for a whistle.
Well, with all the, well, the injury to Marty Havlat, of course, Sharpie, Patrick Sharp being out for almost 4 weeks now. little different look on this last power play with Versteeg, Bufflin, and Eager out on this rush, but a nice rush here by Chris Versteeg, who scored the first goal of the game. A quick whistle, what's Joel Quinville do? He comes back out with the unit that had that great chance right before, with Taze, Brower, Kane, Barker, and Campbell.
Campbell pinched to keep this in. Now Taze to Kane, sweeps it back to Barker. He finds Campbell. Ryan Campbell battles his way in behind the net. Now Kane got it with a little give and go. Patrick Kane dropped it to Barker to Kane. Brower front of the net. Kane taking a look. Slap pass for Taze. He tried to go goal mouth again, but the pass was picked off. Kane has it back. Barker to Kane. Here's the shot and a save by Ward. And boy, Cam Ward's done a heck of a job for the most part controlling many of his rebounds.
Well, speaking about control here, would this be traveling, Pat, in the NBA? Patrick Kane gets it, makes like he's going to throw it. Well, closing the hand on the puck there. Carolina, as soon as that happened, Pat, everybody on the bench there, and Paul Maurice was yelling at the referee. And then right after that, I like what Kane did on the boards there. Made a little hand gesture to get Cam Barker to move across the blue line. And then he came up high and was hoping to get an opportunity to attack that net, and eventually did do that.
Keith for the long slapper, and again, no rebound from Ward, and Gleason aggressively trying to clear Ladd out of the way. Four and a half remains in regulation time. The Hawks lead by one.
Well, fans, log on to ChicagoBlackhawks.com or ChevyDrivesChicago.com to enter the Blackhawks Fan of the Year sweepstakes. Patrick Kane and Jonathan Taze will visit your home if you win as a Blackhawks Fan of the Year. Brought to you by the Chicagoland and Northwest Indiana Chevy dealers. Enter now before time runs out. Imagine that little, hello.
Hello, yeah.
Hi, Jonathan Taze, Patrick Kane here.
Cook for dinner.
Bring your own, kid.
All right, Joe Corvo. And the Canes looking up at a scoreboard clock that is becoming their enemy. Corvo's pass picked off. Nolan couldn't quite retrieve it, however. Brent Seabrook. Rolling forward, here's a chance for Versteeg, cutting in, a drag move right to the net, the backhand, good save by Ward, the rebound deflected up high, and Corvo got it back.
What a rush.
And an errant pass here from the Canes will result in an icing call. They wanted to change, but of course, now cannot, but Chris Versteeg, the longer this game is gone, he's had it on a string.
Well, Chris Versteeg is at his best is when he's moving his feet, and this puts defensemen and defenders back under here. But look at him, he's skating. Now he's able to bring the puck in. Corvo goes for a slide and then a forehand backhand, not able to elevate the puck. But the initial burst of speed. Boy, oh boy, that was dangerous there. Almost a Rutu right in the face. You know, that first initial burst of speed, it puts defensemen back on their heels, and then once you get into the zone, then you could start making your moves and glide a little bit to make those plays. But sleek hands there by Chris Versteeg.
Taze put it deep. They'll greet Seidenberg in the corner. Canes get control of it though, and Cullen goes rink wide to Whitney. Ray Whitney in against Walker. The pass broken up. Good stick there from Patrick Kane. Jalmerson is hoisting this one back the other way. It's going to go too far, however, unless an icing is saved. It is by Hustling Eager. And a centering pass never got to Frazier. It bounced off a skate and up off the netting. But Ben Eager just saved Jalmerson a bit of squawking from the bench.
Dennis Seidenberg was waiting for Cam Ward to play that puck. But he was at the end of the shift and was not able to beat the Hustling Eager. And think the faceoff's going to be 200 feet the other way. And look where it ends up because of the hustle by Eager, negating that icing.
Orville pounds it around the board. Duncan Keith kept it in. Now it's centering pass. Ooh, just out of the wheelhouse of Frazier. And now Keith with the puck taken away by the Canes. Samsonov looks to get it toward the net, but picked off by Keith. Brindamore rings it around. Corvo pinching, trying to keep it in. Could not. Duncan Keith got it out.
Bill Quindle's pretty much gone with 10 forwards here, Pat, in the third period. I haven't seen Peltier. Yeah. I don't think you've seen him at all. I think Adam Birch has had a couple shifts in this third period.
And there's no Brent, so right. This has been shortened indeed by Joel Quenneville. And here's Ladd with a loose puck. Ladd cuts right in, shooting. He tried to go high glove, but missed the target. Down to 2 minutes remaining in the third. 2-1 in favor of the Hawks. Now Stahl left it, and here comes Cole moving in. His shot, blocker save, and a good one by Huey. In behind, Stahl came up with it. Poke check by Seabrook, who then knocked him down. Jammed the puck up the boards. Ladd couldn't get it out. Chased down by Walker. He took a hit to make a play, and here comes Boland. Dave Boland looking for help. Ladd coming in late. Boland's pass, though, hit the leg of Babchuk. And Ruutu now for Carolina. And the clock winding down. Babchuk had it stripped away, and Ward has to stay in the net. Here's Taves, who was checked at the line. LaRose starts back. LaRose tied up at center, a penalty. 63 seconds remaining in the third, and the Hawks will be shorthanded.
Well, the second minor tonight for Jonathan Taves. Trying to deny Chad LaRose that red line to dump the puck in.
So Paul Maurice will take his time. He's got an offensive zone faceoff with 63 seconds left in the third.
Well, tomorrow morning, start your day with the Monsters in the Morning, presented by Next Step Medical Staffing. Tomorrow, the Monsters have Academy Award-nominated actor Chaz Palminteri. Plus, up-to-the-minute traffic, weather, and sports news. Monsters in the Morning with Mike North and Jigs, Dan Jiggets. Tomorrow morning from 6 to 9, only on Comcast Sportsnet.
Boland will be on for the draw along with Frazier. And, of course, 2 and 7 will be the remaining PKers against six attackers with a goal to our left empty. Here's the draw, won by the Canes. Corvo goes to the deep slot. Gleason, that was Cullen rather. Now Cullen makes a look, put it to Corvo. He brings it. Oh, a redirect went up high and wide. Puck held in by the Canes. The Ruutu's in behind. He's hit hard by Seabrook in the corner. Rolled loose to Corvo. To Cullen. Joe Corvo's in the middle. He put it to Ruutu. One-timer. Good save. Huey. And a blowout by Boland. It's loose in front. The Canes have a shot. They score. The game is tied. The Chicago Blackhawks had control of the puck for at least a second and a half. Failed to advance it. And Tomo Ruutu bites the hand that once fed him. Half a minute left, 2-2.
Well, Dave Boland wasn't able to clear the puck. Eric Stahl made a heck of a play to deny Boland the opportunity to clear it, but patience by Ray Whitney. Ruutu going hard to the net. Huey not able to see, goes down and he slides over, gets back to his feet. It almost seemed like on that last replay, Pat, that overhead, it looked like it might have hit Boland and then went into the net. You can probably get another look at that, but outstanding play there by Eric Stahl.
Now, get down to 10 seconds as Barker put it in behind. There's a centering pass from Brower just out of the reach of Toews. And if you think Dave Boland feels bad, how do you think Jonathan Toews feels, the guy who took the penalty, which led to the tying power play goal for the Carolina Hurricanes. They score at 19:33 after a couple of misplays by the younger Blackhawk forwards. Boland, at the age of 22, had control momentarily, unable to clear the puck, and Toews at the age of 20 is the guy who took the penalty late in the third in the neutral zone.
That's just one of those things, Pat. We saw earlier tonight on the Brind'Amour goal, puck will go. Dave Boland just loses an edge, but right there. What? There. There's the effort by Eric Staal. Eric Cole helped out as well. But on the first goal, Brian Campbell lost an edge, and that allowed the Brind'Amour goal to go in and there, and an aggressive move by Paul Maurice to pull the goaltender. Power play, minute and three left. And give Carolina a lot of credit for staying with it and putting the puck past Cristobal Oue as we head to overtime. Well, as we mentioned, the first goal of the game, Sergei Samsonov with a great pass over to Rod Brind'Amour. Carolina with a 1-0 lead. As we got to the second period, Leighton in a 2-on-1. Christopher Stieg beats Cam Ward. Ties it up at one. And then on a power play. Beautiful pass by Patrick Kane after a great read by Cam Barker to get the puck off the side of the net. And then there with, on a power play, time coming off the clock. The former Hawk, 27 seconds remaining. And twos are wild as we head to overtime.
So each team gets a standings point. That is huge for Carolina. They are in a real battle to try to stay in the playoffs in the East.
I know some New York Ranger employees and fans aren't happy right now.
Well, now one more point available. In extra time, in overtime, the Hawks are 4-4 so far this season. They would like to finish it in these next 5 minutes because shootouts haven't been very good for them. Boland. Chipped it ahead. Versteeg trying to get away from a check, could not. And the Canes start back. Seidenberg seems to be ever present here in the late part of this game. Is knocked down along the boards by Seabrook, who's been a huge physical force tonight, but it's loose, and Seabrook got control of it. Here's Versteeg to Toews. Jonathan Toews gains the line, gonna wait for a little help. Toews spins to his forehand. The late man is Campbell. Oops, and it jumped over his blade.
That's happened, that's happened about 7 or 8 times tonight to a lot of different players, but just happened to Campbell like 3 or 4 times that same spot.
He's got the puck again. A long shot by Barker. His wide came off the inboard to Kane, and he hit the goal post. Patrick Kane beat Ward and Drew Iron, and now it's held in by Barker. For Toews with a ring around. It's taken back by Samsonov. The pass is picked off by Barker. And now Campbell takes over. Barker. Circle back to allow more changes to be made. Here's Keith coming on fresh, but he made a bad pass. Barker did a good job to get that out. And Babchuk now for Carolina. Cleared it for Cole. Eric Cole in on Keith. Trying to lower the shoulder, but Keith knocked him down. And the Hawks get control of it back. Lav, backhand pass, bouncing three to Brower, but then swept away to Seabrook. There's Brower to the backhand, floats it in front of the net, just out of the reach of Lav. Andrew Lav to Brent Seabrook. His shot was wide. And Andrew Ladd picked it up. Goes back to Seabrook, a one-timer is off the mark. He picked it up, put it into the corner, and Troy Brower. Now the Canes get it back. Seidenberg again has control of it.
I was just thinking the same thing for White.
That never leaves.
How many times have you said his name?
Ooh, he almost turned it over there, then did. Here's Campbell. Campbell threw it in front. Good coverage there by the Canes. Taken back by Versteeg, across for Campbell. Here's the shot, in the save by Ward. 2 minutes remain in extra time. Barker to Versteeg. Miss Versteeg looks to pick up speed, but coughed it up at center. And the Canes move back in. Here's Whitney, who made that great pass on the tying goal. Whitney had it knocked away. Now a long flipper from Corvo high and wide. Versteeg comes racing back to center. Here's Campbell up with it. Campbell peels off, drops it across. Keith long shot is handled by Ward. And now he decides to play it. We get down to 80 seconds remaining. In overtime, Babchuk. New route to. Heidberg has it again. Anton Babchuk, here to two, center ice. Stahl slipped up with a nice poke check by Keith. Stahl got it back, walks toward the middle. Here's the shot. He just missed the near post. Into the final minute now. Rutu taken away by Keith. It bounced loose to Stahl, and no, Huey just got the left pad there in time. Now a leap pass to Kane, right to the net. He shoots, Ward! Oh, Huey in one end, Ward at the other.
Well, two good chances for Carolina. Stahl had them both, and then watched it pass by Brent Seabrook. Right on the tape, and unfortunately the puck started bouncing on Kane, and I think it rolled the whole way. Wasn't able to settle it down, but a big time stop, as you mentioned, Pat, by Ward.
Now Gleason put it around the boards. And Corvo starts out. Whitney flipped it forward. Chased down by Cullen, tried to center, and Campbell got back in time to pick that off. And we get down to 20 seconds left before a shootout. Ryan Campbell cleared it in to Versteeg to the forehand. His shot, oh, fought off, good save, Ward. And the rebound to the Canes. They fire it forward. Here's Stahl, he's gonna get to the net. Stahl shoots, and a save by Huey. Oh, how about the net finding in overtime tonight?
Oh, beautiful.
Wow, let's catch our breath. A shootout in a moment. We have played 65 minutes, tied at two.
Great goaltending at both ends. Look at a pickup there by Eric Stahl. In on Chris Beaulieu. Puck rolling, not able to elevate the puck. Big time stop from the man from France. The pass by Brent Seabrook, a rolling puck. Patrick Kane, good stop by Cam Ward. And right before that, watch his puck right off the end boards, right back out. And then Patrick Kane comes and elevates the puck like he's supposed to. Clank, right off the crossbar. What chances?
Two shots in overtime for the Canes. They were both really good ones. The Blackhawks had four shots. But we head to a shootout where the Hawks have gone 2-5 in shootouts so far this year. Joel Quenneville chooses to shoot first, and the captain will be the leadoff man.
Five hole here, Jonathan Toews.
That's what he normally likes to do. And you see the great success he's had so far this year. He's going against a real hot goalie. Both these Netminers were terrific tonight. And we wait for the officials to allow the play to get underway. Now ready. And here comes 20-year-old Jonathan Toews. Ward out to greet him. Toews five. Oh, the Hawks have the lead.
Head up all the way to puck in a shooting position. This is just textbook. Right between the legs of Cam Ward, and it's the former Hawk.
You used to hear a lot of cheers in this building. It's different now. And Ruutu, who's made 2 out of 4, converted 2 out of 4. Out comes UA. Ruutu in the forehand. It's 1-1. One quick little fake right there. UA down and watch the fake right there. Not much room there, and Ruutu finds a way to beat UA. Next up is Patrick Kane. Forehand, backhand. That's what he tries, and he scores! I think I'm sitting with Karnak.
Just one move. Little shake and bake, and buries it.
You see Jokinen.
He likes to shoot on the stick side, Pat. He'll come way wide on the right and look for the stick side just where Ruutu went.
Our prognosticator, then he pulls up and he scores. Jokinen. So it's 2-2. Neither goalie able to make a save yet in the shootout.
Watch this little, slight little hesitation there. UA looking for a poke check. Watch him blow some snow right there. Get the goaltender in between for moving out and then coming back. A slight little hesitation.
And David Bolin next up for the Blackhawks. Bolin in on Ward. Off the goalpost. He beat Ward, but it drew iron. And now a save required from Cristobal UA.
No forehand back in here for Davey Bolin. Well, I don't know if Ward got a piece of that or not. Let's see the quick stick, the poke check. Oh yeah, just enough. Just up, almost like a ramp.
And a chance for the Canes to win it. Cullen right in quickly. UA keeps his team alive. Cullen trying to go forehand, and UA denies in the five hole. And we get to extra innings in the shootout. Chris Versteeg has had only one shootout attempt. He's 1-for-2 now, and the Hawks have the lead. The save from UA, and this one's over.
Perfect, perfectly placed.
Sergei Samsonov must score, and here he comes in on UA. Samsonov, forehand, UA, Hawks win! Hawks win for just the third time in 8 shootout tries, and the Hawks able to grab the extra point tonight. The building still full with a thrilling finish. A game in which the Hawks yielded the tying goal with half a minute remaining on a Carolina power play. Both goalies great in overtime. And there is your Lexus Pursuing Perfection player of the game, Chris Versteeg, who scored a goal during the game, had the game decider in the shootout. And the Blackhawks get 2 points with an uplifting win on Madison Street tonight.
Found a way tonight, Pat.
Let's pick up the 3-star selection from Harvey Wittenberg.
The game's number 3-star, the Blackhawks number 55, Ben Eager. The second star of the game from the Blackhawks, number 38, goalie Cristobal Huwe. And the number 1 star of the Blackhawks, number 32, Chris Versteeg. Blackhawk fans, three stars brought to you by Anheuser-Busch, who salutes America's responsible drinkers. Remember, responsibility matters. And now, fans, direct your attention to the Blackhawk bench, where Sarah Kustak from Comstock Sportsnet is with tonight's Bud Star of the game, Chris Versteeg.
Chris, you guys took us down to the wire tonight. What was going through your mind on that last shot?
I don't know. We kind of get tips before the game on where to put it and things like that. So just try to listen to what they tell us to do and go out there and try to execute.
Your goaltender, Cristobal Huey, was tremendous tonight, got the job done between the pipes. What can you say about his play and his final save as well?
He's unbelievable. I mean, that last play where he kind of forced him to miss, I mean, that's what the best goaltenders in the league do. And when you have two of the best goaltenders in the league, they make it fun for the fans every night and they help you win.
Tough loss here at the United Center on Sunday, but you get to come back and give these fans a show. What does it feel like to come out with a victory?
Well, when you lose in front of the best fans in the world, it's tough. So coming out and winning in front of all you guys, it's awesome.
Our number one star, Chris Versteeg, has sent it back upstairs.
All right, Sarah, thank you very much. Our next game on Comcast Sportsnet is Friday. The Columbus Blue Jackets are in town for a 7:30 face-off. Turnoff post-game show's coming up with Josh and Steve. And now for Eddie Olczyk, Pat Foley, hoping you enjoyed the broadcast. We know you enjoyed the thrilling outcome. In a shootout, the Hawks 3, the Hurricanes 2. Hurricanes hadn't been as hot as anybody in the league. The Hawks get 2 points tonight. See you again on Friday. So long, everyone.